Good morning, class. Let us all stand for our prayer.
Miss Aliani Subano, kindly lead the prayer.
Yes, ma'am.
Let us all pray. Then.
The Father and of the Son of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for this day. And we are praying, Father God, that you may your Holy Spirit guide and enlighten us. This we ask in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
So again, good morning, class.
Good morning, Mom K.
Okay, you may take your seat.
Thank you, Mom.
And now, class Bidel, can you check the attendance and give me the list of absent?
Yes, Mom.
Okay, thank you. And now, I want you to count off from 1 to 3 and start with you, Miss Namoka.
1, 2, 3, 1,
2,
3,
1,
2.
Okay, group 1, settle yourself at the right side, group 2 at the center, and group 3 at the left side, okay?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
To our yesterday's lesson to be handled by Ms. Pitao.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good morning once again. Now, we will have our recap on our previous discussion. Okay, what was our previous discussion? Okay, Ms. Namoka.
It's all about part of speech.
Very well, it's all about part of speech. And what are those parts of speech? Ms. Sugano?
The parts of speech are noun and pronoun.
Okay, very well. It's all about noun and pronoun. And now we can give an example about noun and pronoun. Okay, Ms. Ludovice?
An example of noun, Gina and Gina. And an example of pronoun, he or and she.
Okay, very well. You learned so much about noun and pronoun. And now we will have an activity entitled
Who Wants to Be a Millionaire?
And who wants to be a millionaire?
Yeah. Yeah.
Group 1 will be Miss Namoka's group, and Group 2 will be Miss Nodavisi's group, and Group 4 will be Miss Lausi's group. And there will be 5 levels in this game. In the level 1 will be same with me. Level 2 will be raise your thought, and level 3 will be score more, level 4 will be struck to gain, and level 5 will be take or give. Every level responds different amount of money. Since this is a class activity, money is equivalent to points. Level 1, sing with me, 2.2 million rubber is equivalent to 2 points. Level 2 will be raise your thought, 3 million is equivalent rubber to 3 points. Level 3 will be explore more, 4 million is equivalent to 4 points. And level 4, construct again, 5 million is equivalent to 5 points. And level 5, take or give, 6.6 million rubber is equivalent to 6 points. The more representative from the group will get the correct answer, the higher score will be earned by the group. All of the members of the group will be participate. Are we clear on that?
Yes, ma'am!
Okay, thank you.
So, okay, class, and now, welcome to the level 1 of this game. Are you excited?
Yes!
So this game is entitled Sing With Me. And at this juncture, I want you to move your chairs so that you'll have the space. And group 1
will be here. In the center is group 2 and the left side is group 2.
Okay. Okay, so here is the instruction. Each group will be given one bell application and you are going to shake it in order for it to produce sound like this. If you hear this sound, it means you are going to answer. Your group will have the chance to answer the lyrics, the missing lyrics that I will be going to play. Yes. Okay? Understand?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay, so can you get the cell phone, please? So, are you all excited?
Yes!
Wow, it's so nice to hear. Okay, so let's play song number one.
Lights
Nice try, group number three, but the other group will have the chance to answer. Okay, group number one.
You know, ma'am.
The music, if it is, your answer is right. Okay, very good. Beautiful. Everybody sing.
Correct.
Hey, everybody, sing.
Love, I love you, love song, baby, baby.
Hey, very good.
So next participant. So let's play song number three. Okay, group number one. Hear the music again.
Okay, very good. So everybody,
I've been running away.
Okay. So let's participate.
So let's move on to song number four.
Okay, group number two.
Flowers.
Okay, so let's hear again the music. Got 2 points. So, thank
station. And that's it. Thank you. Okay, good job, class. You really have the potential to become a famous singer in the future. Yeah. And you have just shown how eager you are in learning your lesson today.
So let's go. Let's give three claps on that. Okay.
Yes. You want another activity?
Yes! Yes.
Okay, let's have the next activity. And we will call this Rate Your Thought. So, in this activity, the same group. Each question is worth 3 million, equivalent to 3 points. So you will only have 3 minutes to finish this activity. So let's have the first question. And the timers are now. How was the activity for you?
Okay, group 2.
For me, the activity is interesting and quite fun.
Okay, thank you, group 2. The activity is challenging yet fun. Okay, let's have the next question. What have you observed in the lyrics of each song? Okay, group 1.
That's what I have observed from the lyrics of each song is that the author uses figure of speech in order to roll the lyrics.
Okay, thank you, group 1, very well.
In each song, the composer uses figurative language to make an effect. So let's have the next question. What do you think is our topic for today?
Okay, group 3.
I think the topic for today is all about figures of speech.
Yes, thank you, group 3. Our topic for today is all about figures of speech. So,
let's review your score. Group 1 got... Okay, group 1 got 3 points in this activity. And group 2 got 3 points in this activity. And another group 3 got 3 points. So, you equally have 2 points. So,
the first objective will be read by the group 1, and second objective will be read by the group 2, and the third objective will be read by the group 3. So let's start from the group 1.
Objectives. At the end of the 60-minute discussion, the students should be able to discover the figure of speech that shows comparison, specifically simile, metaphor, and personification.
Okay, second group.
Value the figure of speech by giving an example using simile, metaphor, and personification through singing and...
Construct sentences to complete a story and apply the three figures of speech.
Thank you for the participation.
So, now, what is a figure of speech? And I want someone to read the first definition of the figure of speech. Can someone read?
Era.
Figures
Figures of speech are expressions to exaggerating words beyond their literal meaning.
Okay, another one. Namoka!
Figures of speech is a figurative language departs from actual or literal meaning of words to create an effect.
Okay, very good. Who wants to read the examples? Rema.
Time is a thief.
Very good. Next. Ebony.
Wait, my pen is calling me.
That's right. And that's all for our description of our figure of speech.
Okay, so you now know what is figure of speech. Let's proceed now to our level 3, explore more. So in this level, we will have two categories. So in this level, you will gain 4 million equivalent to 4 points. So let's first have a recap to the previous level. So level 1, group 1 and group 2 has 4 points, group 3 has 2 points. In level 2, all the groups gain 3 points. So overall, group 1 has 7 points, group 2 has 7 points, and group 3 has 5 points. So you need to participate for you to have 8 points. So let's have now our activity. It's called Compare Me. So I will show you an object and compare it using like or as and without using like or as. So I will be asking two students to compare an object using like or as and without like or as. So the object is this, a flower. So who wants to compare it to anything using like or as?
Who wants to answer? Okay, group 3.
You are as beautiful as flower.
You are as beautiful as flower. So compare this flower without using like or as. So anyone, okay, group 1.
You are beautiful flower.
You are beautiful flower.
So these are your answers. Okay, we will know if these answers are correct in this level. So simile. Who wants to read that definition in simile? Okay, group 2, Ms. Lovie, do you say?
Simile. Comparing two unlike things using like or as.
Okay, comparing two unlike things using like or as. So your answer, group 3, you are comparing you to a beautiful flower and you are using as. So your example are a simile, okay? So here are more examples in simile. So in life, we have she shines like a star. So she is compared to a star. Next, the dog sleeps like a human. So the dog is compared to a human. They fought like a cat and dog. So they are compared to cats and dogs. Okay, she swims like a fish. So
she is compared to fish.
Okay, so as the cabinet, as the cabinet is as big as elephant. So the cabinet is compared to
elephant.
Okay, the dress is as cheap as dirt. So the dress is compared to
dirt.
So she is as cunning as fox. So she is
comparing to fox.
You were as brave as lion. You are comparing to a lion. Okay. Here's a note. Not all comparison with like or as is simile. So she is as beautiful as flower. So not because you are comparing she and to her mother, it doesn't mean that is simile. And you also use the like or you also use the as, but she and the mother are both human, so you can compare she to her mother. Example, the yellow belt
is as beautiful as a rose. You can't compare the yellow bell to a rose because they are both flowers. So you should compare different kinds of things. So you can compare the both like this. You can compare she to a mother. Okay. Another note, not all sentence with like or as is simile. So something that if there is like or as, it is simile. But no, example is I like you. There's no comparison in this example. So this is not a simile. Okay, understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's now move on to metaphor. Who wants to read the definition of metaphor?
Okay, Miss Namoka.
Metaphor, comparing two unlike things without using like or not.
So,
as you, group one, give an example, you are also comparing you to a beautiful flower, but you are not using as. You are not using as or like, but you are still comparing. Okay, here are examples. Life is a roller coaster. So, the life is compared to roller coaster, the cast on his broken leg was a plaster socket. So the cast was compared to a plaster socket. The world is a stage. The world is compared to
stage.
The kids' room is disaster area. So what's the compared things here?
Kids' room.
Kids' room.
And
disaster area.
Okay, disaster area. No, metaphor. Now, the metaphor is not, it should not be taken literally true. So, not because the world is a stage, it doesn't mean that the world is actually a stage, okay? Life is a roller coaster, that is also not true. These are just shown to show a creative writing. Okay, so you now know what is simile and metaphor. So congratulations on completing the first stage or the first categories and level 3 explore more. So the group 3, in level 3 I mean, group 1 has 2 points, group 2 has 4 points, I mean 4 points. So group 2 has no points and group 3 has 4 points. Okay?
Okay, hello students! Hello!
Hello ma'am!
Okay, so we are now still in the level 3 and we will move to the second category, which is entitled Peace with Everyone!
I'm not a human.
Are you ready to perform this category?
Yes.
Okay, so here is the instructions. Please listen and understand the discussion. So I will show you a picture and create a sentence giving the object or a human emotion or action. So again, I will show you a picture and create a sentence giving the object a human emotion or an action. So here is the picture. Okay, so what did you observe to the picture? Anyone who can tell me what is this? What object is this?
Anyone? Okay, so group 1, Mishina.
That object is an alarm clock.
Alarm clock. Okay, thank you. So that
is an alarm clock. Okay, so since this is a game, so we need to compete with each other. Okay, so each group will think a sentence and create a sentence giving this object, which is the alarm clock, a human emotion or action. So I will give you a couple of minutes to elaborate with your groupmates on what will be the sentence that you can create.
Okay, so time starts now.
Okay, so listen. No one is allowed to answer. Raise your hand
ma'am say go. So that would be the signal. Okay, understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so ready, set?
Ready, set, go! Okay, group two.
The alarm clock yells at me every morning.
Okay, the alarm clock yells at me every morning. So we will see if that sentence is correct. Okay.
So right now, we will proceed to the formal discussion about the word personification. So who can read the definition of personification? One. Okay, Ms. Lebron.
Personification gives object human emotions or actions.
Thank you for that. Okay, so to understand more about the personification, I will give you an example.
Okay. So read everyone. Can you read everyone?
The sun is smiling at me.
Okay, so that is the characteristics of personification. Because personification, it occurs when we give an object, a thing, or an animal, a human characteristics or behavior. So as you can see,
the sun is smiling at me. So may I ask you if you saw a sun who smiles at you?
No.
No, right? Because
the sun can smile literally, right? So this is one of the examples of personification. So I will give you more examples about personification for you to understand clearly about this one. Okay, so here is the next example. Anyone who can read this one?
Okay, group two.
The car danced across the icy road.
Okay, thank you for that. The car danced across the icy road. So may I ask you again if you saw a car who danced?
No,
right? So it is kind of weird if we can see a car who is dancing. Okay, so that is the characteristic again of the personification. So we will go back here for the definition of the personification. So those two are just some examples of personification. So again, always remember that personification is it occurs or it is a figurative language where animals, things, or an object expresses human behavior or characteristics. So are we clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you understand the personification?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that's very nice. Okay, so right now, we will recap the scores from the previous activities up until now, from the previous level. So in level 3, so here are your scores from the first category, which are 4 points, 0 point, and 4 points. So since the group who answered first earlier is the group 2, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so before we will put their scores, let me ask Ms. Or any representative from group 2
to stand. Can they stand in your representative? Okay, Ms. Rema. Okay, may I ask, what is the reason why you gave that example? Or what did you observe from that example?
How we come up with that sentence statement, we observe that in the sentence we use a figurative language and human object, a human action. That is why we call that personification.
Okay, that's correct.
You will gain 4 points. Congratulations to both schools for having 4 points. Okay, job well done, students. So you have finished or accomplished the level 1 to 3. Clap your hands to yourself. Okay, now are you ready for the next level in this session?
Ready!
Okay, you are so energetic.
Yes,
ready. Okay, so our next level is entitled Construct a Game. So in this level, I will give you enough time or a lot of time in order to brainstorm within your group. I think you have 2 minutes. Is that enough?
Yes,
since you have already learned what was the three major types of figures of speech, simile, metaphor, and personification. And I hope you understand deeper to that.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so in this level, you will construct a sentences, or each group will construct sentences continuing the story that the teacher will give. So I will give
a short story and you will continue the story that you have integrated within your group, okay? So students will have 5 minutes to finish the activity. So you have 2 minutes to finish or to wait for me within your group.
Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, your time starts now. So the story is, I was walking like a zombie in the middle of the night. You will continue the story and make sure to identify what type of figure of speech after you constructed the sentence.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay, time's up.
Okay, the story starts. I was walking like a zombie in the middle of the night. Simile.
Okay, group three.
Then suddenly, the tree started to dance. Personification.
Okay. Group one.
The air started to cold like a frozen ice. Simile.
Okay, very good.
Frozen.
Okay, group two.
The pathway is a dark hall. Metaphor.
Okay, very good. Another, group one.
The air whispers in my ears. Personification.
Okay, very good. Okay, group three.
Run like a cheetah.
Okay, very good. So before we proceed. Okay. So before we proceed in the continuation, I will recap your scores. Group three got 10 points, 10 million, and the group one got 10 million also, and group three got 5 million. Okay, continue. Okay, group one.
My song is a walking giant metaphor.
Okay, very good. Another, group two.
Then suddenly, my alarm clock yells at me loudly, and I woke up. It is personification.
Okay, very good. This part? Okay, that's enough. Now we have the addition of the scores in this level. So group one got 15 million. Group two got 10 million. And group three got 10 million. Okay, congratulations.
Congratulations, students, you have completed each and every levels of the different activities given by different teachers. Congratulations. Okay, so now you have come to this level, which is level 5. So entitled Take or Give. So before we begin, did you all understand the discussion?
Yes!
Okay. So, do you have any clarifications by your reactions?
No.
So, if none, let's start the activities. Okay. So, we have here identify the figures of speech used in a poem. So, it's either simile, metaphor, or personification. You are given three options. Okay. So, first option is take the score. Second option, give the points to other group. And the third option is deduct the points from the other group. So those options are your choices. Okay, so on what will you do to your score. So this activity is
over 6 million equivalent points. So this is to test if you truly understand our topic for today.
Okay, so let's have our first question. Okay, who wants to answer? Okay, Ms. Namoka. Can you read first? Metaphor, let's check.
Okay, very good. So what will you do to your scores?
Take the point.
Okay. Number two.
Okay, Miss Pita, kindly read first.
The wind stood up and gave a shout.
He whistled with his fingers and I think it's personification.
Personification. Very good. Correct.
I will take this one.
Thank you. Okay, number three, Miss Rema.
The air is like a mother's hand laid softly on a throbbing room.
It was an answer.
Similarly.
Very good.
Again?
Take the score.
Okay. Number four, Miss Villanueva.
Earth felt the moon and nature rose in, sighing through all her works in signs of
womb.
I think it's
personification. Very good.
Take the points. Okay, for the last number, we have number five. Okay, Miss Wazo.
Fly is a broke-winged bird that cannot fly. My answer is metaphor.
Metaphor, let's check.
Okay, very good. So what will you do to your score?
Take the points.
Okay, so all of the groups have taken their points. Okay, job well done.
Okay, so congratulations everyone. You have completed our final level of all different activities. Okay, so now we are going to total all the scores. So group 1 got 12 points in this level. Group 2 got 6 points and group 3 got 12 points. So let's total. All in all the levels, all the groups got Group 1, 38 points. Group 2, 27 points. And Group 3, 32 points. So congratulations, Group 1. You won the activities. Okay, so assignment. Now, before the assignment, I want you to write all your scores and the group members on the paper and pass it to me, so that I will record it on the class record. Okay, finish. Can you hand it to me now? Okay, thank you very much. For your assignment, research the other types of figures of speech, specifically hyperbole and onomatopoeia.
So kindly arrange your chairs. Everyone. Okay, so that ends our first discussion this morning. Do you have any clarifications?
No.
Okay, very good. So, goodbye, class.